Okay, Angelina Jordan, House of the Rising Sun. Let us watch.
There is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun. And it's been the ruin of many a poor boy. And God, I know I'm
going to listen to that one more, just a quick bit of talking here, because that's what I guess I'm supposed to do, right? It's a reaction channel. Sometimes I just sit here. And it's because I don't really have a choice. I'm mesmerized. So, when I was a kid, I got this record. See, back when I was a kid, there was no cell phones, no internet, no anything. Hard to imagine that nowadays, but there wasn't any of that stuff. And if you wanted to listen to music, you had to listen on the radio, or you had to go buy a record. When I was a kid, there was no 8-tracks, cassettes, CDs, none of that. It hadn't been invented yet. Or if it was, nobody knew about it, because that was your choice, is basically records. And you could buy, for this kind of a song, you could buy them on either a 12-inch record, which was a big round one, or you can get a 45, which was a little round one. And record players had three different speeds on them, 33 and a third, I think it was, 78, and then 45s. That's why they call them 45s. That was 45 revolutions per minute, I guess, is what that stands for. And so you'd set your record player, and if you had the 45s, they had a big hole in the middle. You had to get this plastic insert so it would slide over the metal pole in the middle. Why they didn't just make the hole little like the other one, I don't know. But anyway, it doesn't matter. I always wondered that, because the 78s and the 33 and the thirds slid over, they had a little hole when it went on there. The 45s had a big hole. I don't know what that was. Why would you do that? But anyway, it doesn't matter. Maybe to sell us the little round plastic things, I don't know. So there's another reason that I have no clue about, but I always thought it was interesting. And then you'd bring it home, turn on the record player, and put her on, baby. And I wore out, I don't know how many records of this song. I used to love this song, along with a lot of other ones. But you could wear those records out over a period of time, especially if your record player wasn't a high-quality one. It would be scratchy and all that kind of stuff. But, yeah. Now, I never really knew what the lyrics were all about. Not as a kid, but, you know, eventually, I guess as I got to be an adult, I kind of more understood the lyrics a little bit, but it didn't change my love of the song and the thing by, I think the Animals are the original singer, right? But now Angelina owns the song. It's all hers. It doesn't matter who the original singer was. It doesn't matter how many times I listened to the song. It's now her song. She puts a lot more into it than the original. Although, you know, the original is the original. But, yeah, I mean, Angelina, oh, man, I'll tell you. Nobody does a song like Angelina. She has the ability to touch my soul, reach my heart, and I believe her when she sings. I think that's really what it is. She's genuine and authentic, and she sings from her heart and her soul, and it goes whoop, it goes right into me, okay? And, you know, that's part of what I call the magic sauce with Angelina. She's just got more than most singers. Now, there's a lot of great singers out there right now. Young singers, you know, people that are not quite as young, but still fairly young singers out there just singing their hearts out. And they're really fantastic. They are. But for me, the only one that consistently touches my heart and my soul is this one right here, Angelina. And why? I think it's a combination of a lot of things. Part of it is, too, is that her family has shared so much of her life with us ever since she was a little kid. I just posted a video, 1.5 years old. There was always just a little short out there, this little clip, but now there's like a whole long video of her at that age singing. And it's unbelievable. It's just unbelievable. It's not natural, it doesn't seem like, but it is to her, okay? It's not natural for most people to be singing when they're 1.5 years old. I don't even think you can talk all that good when you're 1.5. Not only is she singing, she's Norwegian, she's singing in English, okay? Let your head wrap around that one for a minute. And maybe they raised her speaking English. I don't really know, but even to be speaking in 1.5 is something. Now you're speaking in different languages, right? I don't know. You tell me what that is, okay? Because I can't put it into words, really. Was genius, prodigy, you name it, right? And her family raised her in such a way to be so, how do you want to say it? Open, honest, caring, loving, inclusive, you name it, okay? All that stuff. She is she's just a good person overall. I think a role model, really, for anybody coming up, you know, any of the young people coming up, especially young girls who can emulate her probably more than young guys could. But anyway, that's just my opinion. Oh, boy, I'll probably get stomped on for that one, but you know, that's the way it is. It's the natural order of things, if you will, in my opinion. So anyway, because I'm old-fashioned, I'm old and old-fashioned. Yeah, is that okay? forgive me. I don't like the fact I had too many birthdays either, but it's the way it is, right? So let's watch this one more time, and then we'll get out of here. Sorry for all the talk, and I was only going to talk for a minute, and I got carried away. Not unusual for me, actually. Quite common.
There is a house in New Orleans, they call the rising sun, and it's been the ruin of many a poor boy, and God, I know I'm a
I've been doing these TikToks. I've been doing like 2 or 3, sometimes 4, 5, 6 stacking them together to make a video. It's a little bit longer than, you know, 17, 18 seconds. This one happens to be a minute and 55, which is a long one, actually. So I'm going to let this one stand alone. Out of respect for Angelina, out of respect for the original artist, out of respect for the original song, but mostly out of respect for Angelina, because I am 100% biased, okay? Angelina is the best singer I've ever heard in my life, and I'm standing on that ground until you can knock me off the hill, okay? And how are you going to do that with somebody that's even better? But it ain't possible, I can tell you that. We've seen Angelina her whole life. She is music, and she lives it, she breathes it, and it's all about music. Everywhere she goes, everything she does, it's all about music, okay? You can't beat that. You can't take somebody off. You can't knock her from the throne. She is music, okay? Has been her whole life, and that ain't going to change. So I hope it doesn't change anyway. It could, but you hope not, right? So anyway, there you go. I'm going to leave Angelina right there on the, right at the pinnacle of my musical choices. Angelina's the one, okay? Have a nice day, guys. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching.